Technology, as we all know, has become a part and parcel of anything and everything that we do today.
Technology has to be simple, but not simplistic.
I think technology also has been the problem in agriculture.
The community institutions play a very important role, and then community resource persons.
There are some other innate inequalities we need to really bring our attention to.
There must be a value there for a farmer.
How does technology enable farmer voice and agency?
Agriculture accounts for about 15% of India's total greenhouse gas emissions. How can we possibly drive tens of millions of independent small-scale producers who are grappling with countless challenges to learn about and adopt such practices? This will require engagement from the entire ecosystem. And the good news is that key stakeholders recognize the potential and are eager to support.
Technology, as we all know, has become a part and parcel of anything and everything that we do today. So how can the same technologies be used for helping farmers who are in far greater need for getting the correct information, getting the right services, and by using technology to help them reduce their income costs, make the agriculture more sustainable, and also to increase their incomes? So the easiest and the simplest way to address that challenge becomes to enable access to the right information to all farmers.
RYSS in Andhra Pradesh and Jivika in Bihar have been such close partners to Digital Green over the years and have been investing in promoting climate smart sustainable livelihoods for rural farmers through a variety of means, while Jivika has been pioneering its efforts through a million strong women SHG network to adopt sustainable practices. RYSS has been investing in landscape-based integrated approaches in Andhra Pradesh, but both have been really strong champions of ensuring that the community themselves, community resource person cater especially, really is the focal point.
We have oversimplified agriculture and we have assumed that there are some neat solutions in the hands of experts. We are forgetting the complexity of nature. We are forgetting that there is so much that we don't know. In fact, what is agriculture to a great extent depends on biodiversity. Hardly 1% of what happens below the soil is known. So we have to transform our thinking and not assume that there are some neat solutions and some great experts have that solution. And then, you know, just through digital mechanism, the solution will go to a farmer. So the role of digital technology in behavior change, to the extent it capacitates the human connection between farmers, is critical.
The community institutions play a very important role, and then community resource persons play a very important role by giving access to this kind of technologies. I said that I have mobile phone to have access to the knowledge and information. That is the power of community.
There are some other innate inequalities we need to really bring our attention to. If we see the total climate financing in the world, only about 2% of the total climate financing is actually coming to smallholder farmers. Four countries in this region, South Asia alone, make it to the top 10 most vulnerable countries in the world on climate. So we really, really need to do something about that. Let's really package our information. Let us really, from a farmer's perspective, number one is, what does a farmer need to know about climate adaptation and how does it affect my income? Number two is, why should I know about climate adaptation?
The Self-Help Group platform is a very powerful platform to kind of empower women and to give women the confidence to actually share practices that they might have implemented on the ground. Also, the need to identify champion farmers and for those champion farmers to actually share the information going forward.
the ground data that's being collected about farmers can really inform models. It can inform, you know, policies around what's working and what isn't working. And then another area we spoke about was around finance, and there must be a value there for a farmer to both collect quality data and share that data.
Technology has to be simple, but not simplistic, in terms of we need to acknowledge the complexities of the situation that we're in. This is also, by the way, not an India-centric problem. This appears to be a problem in many parts of the world. What we need to ensure is that when we're talking about climate smart agriculture, we're talking about farmer incomes, we're talking about the social development indicators that piece of work, most notably nutrition, and the climate benefits.
They need to work on a structure that preserves the privacy and, you know, the individual farmer-driven approach to the whole thing. IDEA is a large, complex system that tries to address the problems with a systematic use and responsible use of technology across the entire value chain. And AI for AI is, you know, a subset of that, which is looking at emerging technologies like AI and IoT and blockchain and drones in the space of agriculture. And of course, in both of them, both of these projects, there is a space for CSA.